Hi. In the roller coaster video, two questions were raised. How to determine the slope of the roller coaster track and how to determine the speed of the roller coaster cart. The funny thing is that both questions can be answered using differentiation. Let me show you how. Let's start with the concept of slope. How is it defined? First, we look at a straight but inclined part of the roller coaster track. When a cart moves from point P to point Q, there is a corresponding horizontal displacement, delta x, and a vertical displacement, delta y. The slope is simply defined as delta y divided by delta x. For example, if delta x equals 10 meter and delta y equals 5 meter, the slope is 0.5. Because the line is straight, it does not matter where we take P and Q. If we take Q twice as far, delta x will double, but so will delta y, so the slope remains the same. We can even take Q on the other side of P. Then delta x is negative, say minus 4 meter. Delta y then equals minus 2 meter, so the quotient remains the same. As you would expect, the slope is a measure of steepness. If the track is steeper, then for a fixed delta x, the corresponding delta y will be larger, and so the slope will be larger. Finally, descent corresponds to a negative slope. If delta x is positive, say 10 meter, the corresponding delta y will be negative, say minus 4 meter. Therefore, the slope will be negative, in this case, minus 0.4. What if the track is not straight? Suppose we want to determine the slope at point P. If we zoom in at the track near P, the track will look approximately straight. So if we take Q close to P and take the quotient of the displacements, we get an approximation of the slope of the track. To improve the approximation, we move Q to closer to P. The quotient of delta y and delta x approaches a limit value. This value is, by definition, the slope at P. Now let us consider the concept of speed. First, suppose that the speed of the roller coaster cart is constant on some part of the track. In that case, you can determine it by measuring the distance, delta x, traveled during a time interval, delta t, and then take the quotient. For constant speed, it does not matter what time interval we take. Now, suppose that the speed is not constant, and we want to determine the speed at time t. Again, we can measure the distance delta x traveled during a time interval delta t and then take the quotient. This will give us the average speed on the time interval, but not the speed at time t. However, if the time interval is small, the speed is approximately constant during the time interval. So the speed at time t is approximately equal to delta x divided by delta t. To make the approximation better, we take delta t smaller and smaller. The quotient of delta x and delta t then approaches some limit value, this speed at time t. We see that both slope and speed can be determined by taking the limit of a quotient. That is exactly what differentiation is. More precisely, suppose a function f and a point with x coordinate equal to a are given. If the x coordinate changes from a to a plus delta x, the function value changes. The vertical increase is equal to f in the point a plus delta x minus f at the point a. The horizontal increase is simply equal to delta x. The quotient of these two is called a difference quotient. Now, we can take the limit of delta x to zero. If this limit exists, the number you obtain is called the derivative of f at x equal to a. It is denoted by f prime of a or df divided by dx in the point a. The whole process of determining the derivative is called differentiation. If you look at the graph, both the difference quotient and the derivative have a geometric interpretation. The difference quotient is precisely the slope of the line connecting the points P and Q on the graph. Now, if we let delta x go to zero, you see that this connecting line approaches a limiting position. The slope of this limiting line is precisely the derivative of f at a. The limiting line itself is called the tangent line to the graph at the point P. It is the unique line with the property that it passes through the point P and has the same slope as the graph in that point. Now, let us return to the original questions. What is slope and what is speed? We have seen that both slope and speed can be interpreted as derivatives. Slope, as the derivative of vertical position y as a function of horizontal position x. Speed, as the derivative of position x as a function of time t. The definition in terms of the limit of a difference quotient may seem abstract, but it provides the basis for many measuring devices. For example, a bicycle computer can measure the time it takes for the wheel to make one revolution. In this case, delta t is the time measured, delta x is the circumference of the wheel. The current speed is approximated by delta x divided by delta t, the difference quotient. Usually this approximation is sufficiently accurate. What if you want to calculate derivatives exactly? Taking limits every time can be cumbersome. In the next section, you will learn how to deal with this. But first, let's practice with the concepts. Good luck!